Let's put some numbers to a crash and see if we can figure out the benefits of slowing down the total amount of time involved in a crash. We've got a car traveling at 27 meters per second, and I'm going to draw diagrams as we go here. So we've got a lovely car. Oh man, what a car. It's traveling with some initial mass times velocity. And then we have a collision that causes it to come to a stop in approximately 1 second. The driver, who weighs 860 newtons, let's go ahead and label this over here. Weight is 860, if I can write, newtons, is protected by a combination of variable tension seatbelt and an airbag that slows velocity such that he comes to a stop in approximately 2.5 seconds. So we have the car during the collision. Trust me, it's the same car. And during the collision, we feel some impulsive force from crashing into a building that is equal to our integral over this time of my collision of f dt. But that's going to be hard. I don't really know what's going on there. So what I'm going to do for part A, it asks for the average force. Lucky me, I can say that's equal to the average force times delta t. And so that combination of my initial linear momentum plus the impulse will end up giving me my final linear momentum of the car. Which is zero. Mass times velocity final is zero. This is a momentum diagram where I'm considering different states, state initial, during the collision, and then finally. We can use that diagram to write our conservation of momentum, or really, we haven't talked about that yet. This is an impulse statement where we say, whatever momentum I start with, plus whatever impulse is acting on me, in this case, we'll use the average form, is equal to my final momentum. This statement is going to be very similar in a lot of cases. Here, our final velocity is zero. And now we can resolve this vector statement into x and y coordinates. Here, really only the x coordinate matters. Let's go ahead and give ourselves an x coordinate and say that the x coordinate version of this vector statement is that mvi minus, because the average force is acting in the negative x direction, this average force times delta t will equal zero. That's one equation. We have one unknown we want to solve for from that equation, this average force. So we can add the F delta T to both sides, divide by delta T on both sides, and we get that my average force is equal to MV over delta T. That would be great if I had all the things to plug in for that. I don't quite. I don't actually have the mass yet. I wrote down the weight, we don't have the mass, but we know the weight is equal to mass times gravity, so the mass is equal to weight over gravity. I can plug in some values for this. I have the weight of 860, we'll divide that by gravity, and we'll get a mass of 87.8 kilograms. Now we have everything we need to plug in here. 87.8 kilograms times my initial velocity of 27 meters per second, and then divided by, for part A, the 2.5 seconds is my stopping time. The units work out as kilogram meters per second squared, or newtons, and we get an average force with a magnitude of 948 newtons. This is a force, so it has a magnitude and a direction. So if I'm reporting that, I could say that my average force is equal to, I might say, 948 newtons to the left, as I've drawn it up there. We weren't given actual diagrams to work off of, so this is just according to how I've drawn it. Part B, we want to know, well, what would it have been if we had stopped in 0.2 seconds instead by banging into the steering wheel? And here we have the answer already. We just need to plug in a new time. So our new average force will be the same thing as before, but now with a new time plugged in. That's all the same. If I can draw a 2. All right. And now 0.2 seconds, which leaves us with 11,853 newtons. That's more precision than we have. Please round reasonably. Let's just go ahead and do that here. 11.8 kilonewtons to the left. Which is significantly higher than the average force we had with the airbags, because the time of impact is over 10 times shorter. Our force of impact, our average force of impact, is over 10 times greater. And that demonstrates the benefits of seatbelts, of airbags, of all that stuff.